Hello and welcome back to Derivatives and Risk Education. In our previous lesson, number 13 in the Derivatives Foundations course, we explored forward rates. We learned that these are interest rates for future periods that are mathematically implied by the current spot rate yield curve through the powerful principle of no arbitrage. Today, in lesson 14, we're going to look at the forward rate agreement, or FRA, which is a key financial instrument that allows market participants to transact based on these forward rates. So what exactly is a forward rate agreement? It's an over-the-counter, or OTC, contract between two parties. It's essentially an agreement made today to exchange a fixed interest rate for a floating interest rate on a notional principal amount for a specific period that begins and ends at defined points in the future. Unlike a bond or a loan, the notional principal itself is typically not exchanged. Instead, the FRA is cash settled. To clarify some of these concepts, let's look at the formula for calculating the cash settlement amount. The cash settlement amount represents the present value of the difference between the interest rate that would accrue on the notional principal at the floating reference rate versus the agreed FRA rate over the contract period. This formula tells us the cash amount paid or received on the settlement date. To understand it fully, let's break down the key components that make up an FRA contract and appear in this formula. First, N, which is the notional principal amount. This is the agreed upon amount on which the interest rate differential is calculated. Second, the agreed FRA rate. This is the fixed interest rate, expressed as an annualized percentage, that the two parties agree upon today for the future contract period. This is the rate we see in the numerator being compared to the reference rate. Third, then, the reference rate. This is the floating interest rate that the agreed FRA rate will be compared against in the future. For modern forward rate agreements, this will be a risk-free rate like SOFR for US dollars, SONIA for British pounds, or ESTR for euros. If you are watching a video about FRAs or swaps and it mentions LIBOR, then you're looking at outdated content. The LIBOR rate was always used in the past, but it's now been completely replaced. You can watch my risk-free rate video for more about this if you like. Now, we see that the REF rate appears in both the numerator and the denominator of our settlement formula. This REF rate is a specific rate that is determined on or just before the settlement date. It's the market interest rate for the contract period tau observed in the market on the settlement date. This is the rate at which funds could actually be invested or borrowed in the market for that specific future period, as of the settlement date. In practice, the exact moment this reference rate is officially determined or fixed for the purpose of the FRA settlement might occur a few business days before the actual settlement date, according to market conventions for that specific reference rate. Fourth, the contract period. This is the specific period in the future over which the interest rate comparison is made. The length of this period is crucial and is represented by tau, the day count fraction for the period according to a specified day count convention. Day count conventions like actual 360 or 3360 determine how this fraction of a year is calculated. Understanding these conventions is important for precision in finance. I might cover them in a separate deep dive video. Finally, the settlement date. This is the date when the cash difference between the two rates is actually paid. For standard forward rate agreements, the settlement date is typically the start date of the contract period. Let's look at the logic of the formula. The numerator, REF rate minus FRA rate times tau, represents the difference in interest calculated at the two rates over the period. This difference is conceptually earned or owed over the contract period, as if it were payable on the end date. However, since the settlement happens on the start date, which is before the contract period begins, we need to discount this conceptual difference back from the end date to the start date. The rate used for this discounting is the same REF rate, the market rate for the period observed on the settlement date. The discount factor applied is 1 over 1 plus the REF rate times tau. If you're unsure about the discounting, watch my time value of money video. So, the formula calculates the difference in interest and then discounts it back to the settlement date. If the ref rate observed on the settlement date is higher than the agreed FRA rate, the term ref rate minus FRA rate is positive. This means the party who agreed to pay the fixed FRA rate will receive a payment from the other party. If the ref rate is lower than the agreed rate, the term is negative, and that means the party who agreed to pay the fixed rate will make a payment to the other party. Now, in lesson 13, we saw that the no arbitrage principle dictates a specific relationship between spot rates and forward rates. This same principle ensures that the agreed FRA rate for a future period is equal to the market implied forward rate for that same period and same underlying reference rate derived from the yield curve. This consistency is informed by arbitrage trading between the FRA market and the markets for underlying instruments like overnight index swaps or risk-free rate futures that are used to build that yield curve. Let's walk through a simple numerical example applying this formula. Imagine a forward rate agreement with a notional principal N, 1 million, an agreed FRA rate of 4% or 0.04, a contract period of 90 days, so tau is 90 divided by 360, so a quarter, using the actual 360-day count. Settlement date is 6 months from today, and on this settlement date, the market interest rate for a 90-day period, the ref rate is observed. Scenario 1, the ref rate is higher. Suppose the observed ref rate on the settlement date is 4.5%. The cash settlement is 1 million times 4.5% minus 4% times a quarter divided by 1 plus 4.5% times a quarter, which is about 1236.05. In this scenario, since the floating rate is higher, the party who agreed to pay the fixed 4% rate receives approximately 1236 on the settlement date. Scenario 2, the ref rate is lower. Suppose the ref rate on the settlement date is 3.5%. The cash settlement then is again the 1 million times 3.5% minus 4% times a quarter divided by 1 plus 3.5% times a quarter, so it's about negative 1239. This scenario, since the floating rate is lower, the party who agreed to pay the fixed 4% rate pays approximately 1239 on the settlement date. Note that in both cases, the ref rate is different from the FRA rate by 0.5%, but the absolute value of the settlement amounts is not the same because the discounting happens at different rates. Forward rate agreements are powerful tools used for various reasons in finance. Hedging: company expecting to borrow money in the future at a floating rate can use a forward rate agreement to lock in an effective interest rate today, protecting against rising rates. Conversely, a company expecting to lend money can hedge against falling rates. And for speculation, traders can take a view on whether future interest rates will be higher or lower than the current market implied forward rates. If they expect rates to rise, they might enter an FRA agreeing to pay the fixed rate. If they expect rates to fall, they might agree to receive the fixed rate. So, in this lesson, we've defined forward rate agreements, learned the formula for calculating their cash settlement on the settlement date, broken down the key components which feature in that formula, and explored their main uses in hedging and speculation. Soon, we'll dive into two other important interest rate derivatives, interest rate futures, and swaps. If you found this lesson helpful, please give it a like and consider subscribing to the channel if you haven't already. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them below. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.